And here we have Mother's Day at Mamo Rojas's. Carl Chris and Kyle Rojas Wilson.
See you later, Jack. Flowers.
As the sun sets in the west, in Westport, we contemplate the golden coast of California. School is out, and trips, plans have been made. So we say so long to 4229 Holly. And we begin our journey to California.
Today? And it's what called a Ninja Turtle.
And the master of all that he surveys is Sir Kyle Wilson. The other running deer child that you saw was Master Carl Chris Wilson. The two Wilson boys at 4229 Holly. And so we also survey the toys of the trade. Master Wilson and Sir Kyle's beautiful collection of vintage 80s toys. Here's an Ozark dogwood thrown in. And of course, with toys comes the neighborhood crowd. The kids who live in the neighborhood. There's Felix, sidekick. Sidekick to Carl Chris. All right, you guys, leave Kyle alone or I'll come over there and tie you both in knots. So there we have Play on Holly Street as the sun sets into the west. Everybody contemplating the Gold Coast of California.
Yeah. Well, here we are at Disneyland early the next morning after arriving. We had a pretty fast day yesterday arriving. Chris was a little disappointed that the limo didn't pick us up. We had to take a yellow cab instead. Of course, he would have been disappointed with the limo, it not being a stretch, of course. And we made the flight. It was an enjoyable flight. We landed at LA International, got a nice little red convertible car, took off for Disneyland through Los Angeles traffic. It took longer to get from the LA airport to Disneyland, which is inner city LA, just across town, than it took to get from Kansas City to Los Angeles yesterday. I guess success is just too much here. Too many people creating too much traffic. At Disneyland, we enjoyed a nice swim and a good night's sleep, and are now off on the monorail or the tram to the park, where we'll see the characters, have brunch, and enjoy what Disneyland has to offer. On the freeway coming here yesterday, I asked everyone what they liked most about California, LA, in their first hour here. I, of course, said the palm trees, as you can see. Victoria said everything but the smog. Carl Chris said limos. There were a lot. Long white stretches were his favorite. And Kyle said he just hoped the candy was good. Well, here we are back at the film. We're at Disneyland, where, as you can plainly see, there's a lot of activity going on.
Service begins soon. Reservations are limited, so call your travel. Legend or Star Tours today. Come spend an afternoon or the entire day with the lovable Ewoks in their charming tribal villages. It's a fun-filled visit that you and your family will remember forever. Just ask for the Endor Express, available only from Star Tours. Non-stop flights leave every few minutes, so don't delay. Visit Endor today.
19 non-stop service to Endor is now ready for boarding at gate number 1. All passengers, please proceed to the boarding area immediately.
I think these new transports have a mind of their own.
Your attention, please. All intermilitary travelers must have a current passport and the necessary visas prior to leaving the spaceport.
Of good and evil, where a small group struggles to bring freedom to the countless worlds of despair. A ragtag band led by the infamous Captain Evil.
Thank you. either to the rear and on the island side, or at least sit there. Again, we have to please pass your descent down to there and make that camera very well sure.
Well, after a nice, relaxing lunch in the French Market here at Disneyland, we had a chance to reflect and meditate about the morning, discuss what we liked, and I vowed to be a better cameraman the rest of the afternoon. You'll notice I'm zooming quite well here. So we leave the French Market to resume our adventure in This is the haunted house. As haunted houses go, it was better than most. Nice ghost. One of the things I wanted to explain about Disneyland is the long, long lines. This thing has just got endless, endless, and endless amounts of lines. They weave you through webs, they make you wait much longer, always, than the ride takes. But Pirates of the Caribbean is supposed to be wet and wild and good, and it's hot. We have a restaurant inside the cave here of Pirates of the Caribbean.
Be careful, man.
We come inside here and it's like being at night.
We can't
tell Carl Chris likes the pirate. He's always fantasized about pirates. There's lots of pirates, swords.
Now we're in Adventureland. Probably the most famous ride in the park, which is the safari boat ride. We're going to take a safari boat ride.
Where are you from?
Kansas City. Where are you from?
Skip.
Great.
Welcome aboard.
Take a look up there, but don't wave at him. Just look. That's a preview of the strange and exotic creatures you'll be seeing today in the Jungle Cruise. Welcome aboard the SS Minnow. My name is Gilligan, and I'll be your skipper for explorers again today. It just entered the mouth of the Irrawaddy River of Burma into a tropical rainforest where it rains 368 days a year. Now take a look around. You're going to be able to see many varieties of plastic plant life growing here. And there are three toucans. Now that's also known as a six pack. Right, rare species of hornbill. About to become a little horn bear. The old smiley the croc right there. No. There is an ancient shrine built by an ancient shriner. No, we're in the city. I want to slowly be climbed by the jungle. There are three mechanical king cobras up there, folks. I mean, 500 pound single tiger. Ooh. That is Ganesha, the Indian elephant god, guarding the sacred pool of Indian. Please go right ahead. Go right ahead. Do that check. They all have their trunks on. They all have their trunks on. Hopefully nothing. Right here. For Disneyland train to breakfast. Isn't it amazing how life like those ducks look? Look at that. Audio animatronics is just simply amazing. Don't go, oh. Gosh, I didn't even tell a joke, God. Here is a crocodile and a gorilla. Now the crocodile is the one in the water. Oh, I might have cut this a little too short. Get wet back there, don't worry about it. It's artificial water. That is an African bush elephant. It's closely related to President George Bush, but this one's a better speaker. Alright, the Barbara Bush elephant. Baboon family is coming down the water section. Pat, Debbie, and Daniel Baboon. And that's our hairdresser there, Vidal Baboon. Now, the striped animals there are... But I don't think we don't need to worry about today, folks, because native summits and hippos are only dangerous when we glitter here in the blood bubbles. So, Sosman, I know, if you're going to try and charge our boat. Ah, oh, but still, I'm adding to the money. Well, we're not out of trouble yet here, folks. We just entered Headhunter Country. Over here on the right, you'll see some native artsy craft. Art's the one on top. Art's the one on top. Yeah. Oh, they're celebrating the kill of that lion there. Now, you can tell that lion's dead, because lions, they normally don't stand that way. Good thing the backside, because yesterday over here, very special. It looks like there, folks. Look real close. That's the backside of water. Look at the back window if you don't see the side of water looks like. Do you see that? The side of water? Sure. These are some man-made rock structures built about 35 years ago. I need to tell you that, because lately, people have just been taking it for granted. Actually, I need to tell you that for sedimentary reasons. Hopefully. Oh, and the tree there is a resident snake. His name's Monty. Monty Python, that is. Pretty good. Scooby's not big water buffalo there.
us a little bit left.
Anyone want to go to the bathroom?
As we leave Adventureland, we are going to go to the monorail back to the hotel, the Disneyland Hotel. The flowers and shrubbery here, by the way, is gorgeous.
The new Mark V monorails, an advanced design of the first daily operating monorail system in the Western Hemisphere, introduced right here at Disneyland. We're traveling along a 2.5 mile highway in the sky, en route to the Disneyland Hotel, our next stop. We're now cruising at 30 miles per hour alongside Harbor Boulevard, probably the road you use to enter Disneyland. When Disneyland opened in 1955, most of the surrounding land consisted of orange groves and open fields. Needless to say, things have changed quite a bit since then.
Hey, hey, Chris, what do you think about Disneyland?
Okay.
What do you think about Disneyland?
Fun. Yeah, very fun.
Tell me what your spiel is, you know, give me your speech.
When I grow up, I'm gonna move here, I'm gonna take my wife and move here, and then my kids grow up in this hotel.
You're gonna live in the Disneyland Hotel?
Yeah.
What are you all gonna do?
Have fun. Let's go to the toy store.
Go to the toy store? Well, here it is the next morning at Disneyland Hotel. The gang is up and we're ready to head back to Disneyland.
We're gonna try and win a new old car.
Yeah, and we're gonna give it to Daddy's friend.
So
we could do this one. No, because if we drive it, we have to order a car to a plane to get it through that.
We can drive it.
No, it's the desert.
So what?
The desert's dangerous.
We're going to do another all-nighter here at Disneyland.
And if I won, I'm going to give it to Dad's friend. If those guys win, they can keep it.
Well, who would that be?
Room service?
And here we are looking out our hotel window. There's a pool, and there's palm trees. And so, this is your key grip and director telling you that we will make a better film today and we will try to be more consistent with what we are shooting and the steadiness with which we are shooting. There will also be a story, and the ending will be the electric parade as we leave Disneyland this evening. I promise you a spectacular. We're off to Disneyland. Yesterday evening we ended up going back for the electric parade, which was a spectacular. And we did the star tours again. This time we were in the front. Quite realistic. And ended up having several malts and shakes at the old Carnation milkshake shop on Main Street in Disneyland. Well, so it's back to short rides and long lines. Disneyland, day two, here we come. It's lovely. Lights, camera, action. Here we are, getting ready to go back to Disneyland for the day, and we are taking the monorail, riding in the front compartment. Kyle, you ready to go to Disneyland?
Yeah.
You ready to go to Disneyland, Kyle? Okay. How about you, Carl Chris?
Yeah.
Do you like Disneyland?
Yeah.
What do you think about Southern California?
Okay.
Just okay?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's good.
What do you like most about Southern California?
Star Trek and Star Tours.
In Disneyland?
Yeah.
What about just in general in Southern California? What do you like?
Swimming.
You can do that at the farm.
So what? Yeah. So it's not the same pool. Because it's bigger.
You like swimming?
Mm-hmm.
Kyle, what do you like about Southern California? What do you like?
Popcorn.
You like the popcorn? What else?
Chippendale.
And what else?
Chippendale.
Chippendale? You like Chippendale? Okay. All right. Well, I think we're about ready to go here on the old monorail. So, we'll come back when it's departure time from the Disneyland Hotel.
Ooh.
To those of you who have just joined us, welcome aboard. For your safety, we ask that you keep your hands and arms inside the cabin during our journey. Remain seated, and no smoking, please. Thank you. We're traveling aboard the first daily operating monorail system in America, en route to Tomorrowland. The Mark V monorail is the latest development in innovative transportation systems. The Mark V's were designed for a top speed of 70 miles per hour. But here at the Magic Kingdom, the Disneyland Skyway Patrol sees to it that we cruise along at a comfortable 35 miles per hour. Below us is the Autopia, where anyone can sit behind the wheel of a sporty convertible, and it's okay to drive without a license. Below us is Submarine Lagoon, where underwater ships voyage beneath the North Pole to explore the mysterious world of liquid space. Towering above is the majestic Matterhorn. There you can enjoy a thrilling bobsled run, gliding through crystal caverns and racing down icy slopes. We're now above the motorboat cruise, where young skippers pilot their own private yachts on a cruise through narrow straits and bubbling rapids. Winding around and above Tomorrowland is the People Mover. This automated transportation system was first introduced here in the Magic Kingdom. Someday, you may see similar systems efficiently carrying passengers in your own hometown. We're now turning toward Fantasyland, where you can join in the adventures of Peter Pan, Snow White, Pinocchio, and other favorite Disney characters. Nearby is one of the most popular Disneyland attractions, It's a Small World. As we approach Matterhorn Mountain, we'd like to remind you to keep your hands and arms inside the monorail. Approaching the Tomorrowland monorail station, our final destination. From here, you'll disembark into the world of the future. Tomorrowland is the home base of Captain EO and the intergalactic adventures of Space Mountain and Star Tours. Please remain seated until the monorail comes to a complete stop. Then, remember to collect your belongings and watch your head and your step as you exit. This is Tomorrowland. Thank you for traveling aboard the Disneyland monorail.
Ready?
Here we go. Submarine ride at Disneyland. The Enchanted Castle at Disneyland. This is the castle you see in all the pictures on the Disney Channel. This is the Disneyland Castle. The castle is in a beautiful, beautiful setting.
Everybody go up to the entrance, I'll take a picture. Everybody go up to the entrance, I'll take a picture. Go with Dad.
Victoria.
Oh,
The Mad Hatters, where this happens. Sizes 6 to 10, I guess. The Mad Hatter.
Dad, Daddy, where are you going? Yeah. That man's coming. Come back here.
Let's go.
I'll just push up. He can't.
Listen, get to the spot they gotta go.
Giving this Corvette away. Chris and I entered a whole bunch of guesses as to how many yo-yos were inside of it. It'd be a real hoot if we won it. I'd have to ask him to borrow the car if one of his wins. That might be a humbling thing to do. Somebody up there on the mountain, or somebody's. They pay mountain climbers to climb that mountain all day. Would you like to have a job, and they ask you what you do, and you say, well, I climb the mountain Matterhorn at Disneyland. Some people wouldn't believe that. Here at the train station at Disneyland, getting ready to leave. Beautiful old train station.
Welcome aboard the Disneyland Railroad. While we're moving, please remain seated and keep your hands and arms inside the train. And no smoking, please. We've doused the smoking lamp. On our round-trip tour of the Magic Kingdom, we'll be stopping at Frontierland, Videopolis, and Tomorrowland. And then wheeling on through the Grand Canyon and a fascinating primeval world. The coach you're riding in is tied to one of four genuine steam locomotives of the Disneyland Railroad. Since they've been running this line, these trains have covered enough track to stretch around the world 150 times.
Once again, for health safety, please keep your eyes
square. Frontierland Station.
Are we getting off?
See you later. Well, we're back at the haunted house.
Where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the best view of the paintings, step away from the walls and move toward the dead center of the gallery.
This is the inside of the haunted house. It's got wallpaper exactly like in our house.
Almost as though you sense well or not. Quieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching? Or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge. To find a way out. Of course, there's always my way.
Send us a message from somewhere beyond. Goblins and ghoulies from last Halloween.
We're here at Critter Country. Coming out of the ghost house, which you see here.
Okay, Shell is hungry, Daddy.
Yeah, we're gonna go eat.
She's tired.
Oh,
good.
That one. This is Splash Mountain, Critter Country. Splash Mountain in Critter Country is a new ride that opens in the summer of 89, which is the summer that we are here. As you can see, it's a very steep fall, but you land in water and it just splashes up real big, so I imagine it's a pretty safe and tame ride to take. It just looks scary and probably is a little. Okay, we're now at Storybook Place.
in Fantasyland, where you'll see boats go through this canal and into the whale's mouth, on to hear the story of Pinocchio and others. Fantasyland is for all the fairy tales Disney does for the young children to enjoy. Well, we're back here to ride the sky lift over through Matterhorn Mountain. We went back and saw Captain EO again. I guess that we went back to see the ghost house because Victoria wanted to. Then we went back and saw Star Tours because Carl Chris wanted to. And I guess we went back and saw Captain EO because I wanted to. It is really a very good 3D film, technologically very advanced for 3D. I think you'll see more of this type of film work. Kyle, of course, he's ready to do everything again. And one of the things he wanted to do again, especially, was the Sky Bucket ride. He really liked that. Yeah. We're here at Alice in Wonderland ride, something that Carl Chris wanted to do. Has been wanting to do for a while. It's a charming little ride. Last stop here for the afternoon is It's a Small World. Doesn't look small to me. Different cultures from different countries, illustrated by these moving mannequins. It's an array of overwhelming movement from the various countries. China. Old China, that is. Well, here we are back at Disneyland for our final evening at the park. I don't know if I'll be too sad to say so long to the land of big nipped mamas and scrub-faced suburban kids, where there are longer lines than there are rides always, and lots and lots and lots of people. Southern California is choking on its own success, in my opinion. There are just too many people doing the same thing out here. There's a reason. Climate's beautiful. These luscious flowers are testimony to the climate. So we'll ponder the palm tree and head on over to the electric parade.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Way up here. Hi. Are you all having fun at Disneyland tonight? Yeah? Me and Elliot love Disneyland, but he has trouble getting on some of the rides. He's a little too big. Hi. Hi down there. Well, you gonna say hi to Elliot too? He likes that. Gonna say hi back, buddy? Well, don't be afraid. Elliot's a nice dragon. He won't hurt anybody. Hi.
Y'all have a fun watching the rain.
here's wishing on the moon that I got this taped. We'll find out when we see it. The Electrical Parade, Disneyland. We'll follow it to the town square. As does the whole crowd. The highlight of an evening at... We're going to do the safari ride again. Everybody wants to get in the safari boat and make the trip around the lagoon.
Look, there's no line. We've seen it before, but we thought, boy, to be in this short line.
Well, we've come off the safari and done the Pirates of the Caribbean again. Everything is closing down here at Disneyland. It's time for us to go home. The old train whistle is saying it's late. So we'll bid adieu to Disneyland and what made it possible. Well, we're high here in the Hollywood Hills, about to enter Universal Studios. Well, there's a couple of clowns for you. They ought to be in movies. I wonder if we can get one of them discovered today. This kid here would probably make it in the pictures. He's usually cutting up quite a bit. This one has potential. Song and Dance Man's what he is. Again, we're in sunny Southern California. LA area, the Hollywood Hills, at Universal Studio. Maybe a shoot 'em up star. Well, I don't think we'll take the camera into Universal Studios on our tour. I mean, if there's anything worth filming in there, they'll film it and sell it to us at the box office. It's the American way. Hollywood. Hollywood. Now turning the corner in Santa Barbara, California on La Marina Drive. At the home of my friend the Appletons, who live in this quaint little house on a hill overlooking the harbor at Santa Barbara. This house, as you can see, is a modest but well maintained and cute house, but the view is spectacular. Because below this park, which sets high on a bluff, is the marina at Santa Barbara and the beach. I am standing in my friend the Appleton's front yard. Let's take a closer look at that beach.
Did you have it on?
Yeah. That was Mr. Appleton that just ran by and is now being recorded by the video camera as he trots back to the grill, where he's preparing some nice steaks for us. There's Kyle, Mr. Kyle. Mr. Kyle.
Hi, Dad.
Walk over here in front of the beach. Walk over here in the yard. Over this way. Over this way. Turn around. Walk back this way a little bit and get in front of the beach. There we go. Stay right there. And give us a nice big smile. Is that a nice big smile? Okay, are you having fun in California?
Yes.
Okay. Well, there's Carl Chris. And Kyle, how do you like California?
Swimming.
What else?
Palm trees. There's palm trees. Disneyland was okay. And I found a box. 16 limos, and California is pretty neat.
You like the beaches?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we may come back to California, Carl Chris.
I'll be happy.
You'll be what?
Happy.
All right. Here I am sitting in a chair out in the Appleton's yard, gazing at a palm tree that looks down upon two rowdy boys, Kyle and Carl Chris. This one here is the next James Dean. Give us a smile there. We'll have to fix his teeth, I guess. We're looking out over the beach still, of course. The sailboats in the harbor, and a panoramic view that takes us to the park across the street, Shoreline Park, which is on a bluff. Below us are surfers. You guys want to go surfing?
Yeah. He doesn't, because he's going to get thrown off the board.
We're going surfing. Now can you swim?
The Appletons leased this house. The owner calls it his million-dollar view. It's just a little lot, but it has a very good view, and I have surveyed real estate prices in this area, this Santa Barbara city, and know that he probably is right in assuming that this is a million-dollar view. Oh, Chris. You like California?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Okay.
Kyle.
What?
You like California? You like California?
Yeah. Kyle, what kind of day is it? What kind of day is it? What kind of day is it? Is it a pretty day? Let's go in the house, see what's cooking for dinner. Okay. In this little paradise of Santa Barbara.
Hey, buddy.
That's Linda Appleton.
You're on the air. You're making a movie now.
Hanging the boots upside down. Linda, don't drop him on his head. They'll have evidence, man.
Is the blood rushing to your head yet? Put your hands down and catch yourself, you idiot.
Oh, God.
Yeah, you know.
There's Steven.
Carl, get out of here!
You can get on TV. We're going to all see it tonight. You know, Steve, can you get Linda's brother-in-law? I mean, Linda's brother on it? My brother-in-law?
You bet.
He's a good-looking dude.
Hey, stay out of my shot.
Hey, you have to get my earrings in.
We're now looking out of the kitchen window back on the harbor and the beach.
Mm-hmm. Okay, here's my earrings. You have to get these in.
They've been playing gypsy, making earrings here at the
there you go. You can see
the El Rancho Appleton.
Let's see what's Chris made there. Okay. Where's mom? Look at the ones Linda made. Aren't those cool? See?
This is a new style, Steve. What do you think?
Got bolts and washers on them.
Yeah, that's cool.
You like them? Like the yellow better?
I like the red better.
And she made the yellow ones for Crystal. Hey, here comes Chris.
Hey.
He's cool.
Get up here, Chris.
Hey, Chris, come on over here. Let's see what you look like over here with me. Let's get all the good-looking guys right here in the row.
Yeah, cops. You guys gotta put this back.
We've got the answer to the next James Dean here with us today.
There he is, right there. Mr. Cool. Kyle's shoving it in. Kyle's been dipping his salsa here. Haven't you, Kyle? That's it, yeah.
Learning how to eat.
All across here from Shoreline Park. We'll zoom in on it.
Look at those guys, how fast they're riding uphill. And they're not even sweating.
Hello.
Look, here's our style, right? Here's
yeah,
this guy.
Lynn and I come up this hill on our bicycle.
Walking.
We're going slow like that guy. This is Steve. This is Carl. I mean, Steve. This is Carl's souvenir. Mm.
Quiet, quiet.
Hey, looky here. Hey, Carl. Look at Kyle dipping. Get this right on camera. He's doing the real California stuff. You dip your thing in there, Kyle, like you've been doing. Show Dad so he can get it on tape. Look at that. Boy, he's just a true Californian dipping that salsa.
Looks like a beach boy to me.
Yeah, he is.
He looks like a dirt dog. Could you get one of those glasses?
Carl Chris.
Yeah. I don't want some.
There you go.
I want one.
You want one too? Okay, there you go.
Well, we've come back outside and are viewing the harbor again. Sailboats out there. And the steaks are being prepared.
Yeah, when you put it off the cook, like sausage and hot dogs.
No, this is it. This is what we're cooking here.
Man, that's not quick.
Huh?
Yeah. Chef and his lieutenants.
Here's Chef Kyle. Yeah.
It's about time to eat here in Santa Barbara as we panorama the bay and the beach.
Hey Carl, how do you like your tri-tip? Medium rare, well, rare, what do you like?
Medium rare.
Medium rare. You want to flip it over?
And we focus in on my favorite subject for the ending, the palm trees of California, which by the way are all planted here. None of them are native. But American ingenuity has made paradise here on the West Coast, the Gold Coast of California.
Did you get him on film?
Hi, everybody!
Hey, Kyle.
Come
in here and be in the picture with your dad. This is your director. I hope you've enjoyed this film as much as I've enjoyed making it. It's a great trip. It's a great film, I hope. We'll see it.
Come on, Chris, get on here.
In your local box office. Of course, we are in California. Film sells. Here's my two sons, who have played a co-starring role, and our host in Santa Barbara.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for having us here. Okay, now you just push the red button again.
We are at Los Angeles International Airport. Having left Santa Barbara this a.m., driving down the coast on 101, where at Santa Barbara we took 101 to Santa Monica and then took Route 1 down to Venice, where we went to Muscle Beach and saw what all the people were doing on the beach there. Then we came over to Hollywood, made a circle there, saw the sign, traveled the Sunset Strip back to the freeway to the airport, and have now arrived at the airport, ready to depart to Kansas City. We say goodbye to the palm trees and look for the day that we can return to the LA area and that Gold Coast of California. So here we are back at 4229 Holly. Home sweet home. Back to the toys, other amenities of Holly Street. And we're arriving at Wilson Valley Farms now. Where we will spend a nice visit with the family and tell them about our trip to California. Wake up, Kyle, we're at the farm. Here's the Wilson Valley as we enter this sunny day. First home is that of Earl Wilson. It looks like nobody's at home, so we'll go on down to the main house. Hay's been cut and rolled up down here. As you can see,